like the business mindset of Trump and how he's really encouraged the working class. You know, the executive order he come out with, reducing the payroll tax, that helped Americans, that helped working class. And why Democrats would not be on board for supporting working class is just very foreign to me. I'm like, man, these are people hurting from all the political policies of this COVID. You know, let's get the new government off the neck of the American people and we'll take care of ourselves.
Michael Edding, thank you. I really appreciate you being with us, and hopefully at the very least, people will, listeners will be able to help cancel out those activists out there that are trying to do harm to your business because of your political beliefs. And again, appreciate you being with us this morning. And hope we can have a good time out there working. And we'll be glad when you're back in Springfield.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, you bet. Take care, Springfield's Talk 1041. You're listening to the best evening read on Springfield's Talk 1041.
Watch out for some wet streets in parts of the Ozarks this morning. Highway 13 between Springfield and Bolivar. We've had some pretty heavy rainfall in that area, especially around Morrisville and before Pleasant Home. And also up to the west of Springfield, around the Aurora area, had some rain this morning. No crashes to tell you about, though, in the Springfield area. From the KTTS Go Patrol Traffic Center, I'm Don Lewisacre.
According to the Social Security Administration, there are over 9,000 combinations for how you can take Social Security. Choose wrong, and you can leave thousands on the table. Hi, I'm Ken Moray, founder of Retirement Planners of America. Social Security can be very complex. You can receive a free Social Security consultation. We'll help you choose the option and build a plan to help your money last as long as you do.
Call for your free consultation now. 800-375-1159. 800-375-1159.
Gathering signatures for recall needed. Another reason to do it. Here you go.
Well, and people probably wonder when I interrupt you is that we're still having to do this on the phone, that we can't sit and do the radio in person because of the COVID scare here. But the frustrating thing is that, there are legitimate reasons why they brought the hearing, because she had, a specific financial interest and contract with the city, and, whether it went through the city company or not. And so, I would be, I spoke up a lot during my, I call it trial, it's more like a trial, during my trial, saying, that I was innocent, and I was very vocal about it, And so, if I was her, I would say, I want to get this over with, because, it makes, there's a dark cloud hanging over me. It makes you wonder, because people that are innocent are pretty loud and, want to get it over with.
I will repeat my prediction from when this very first came up, and that is that they would just make it quietly go away. She's one of theirs, and they don't put, these rules that are set up in their mind, they only apply to corrupt people, and they're not corrupt, and so, it's no big deal. Any sort of financial benefit or a company may have gotten, despite the fact that the city charter says directly or indirectly, anyone who does that shall be removed from the council. But that's meant for bad, corrupt people. And she's one of us. She's a good person. So, and that what would happen is she would just quietly, not run for re-election. And they would kick this down the road far enough to where they can eventually say, well, there's really no need to push this further. I mean, she's not on the council anymore, and it would just be a waste of taxpayer dollars. And in the end, all we would do is tell her she couldn't be on the council if she were found guilty of these things, and she's already not on the council. So we're just going to go ahead and, for the sake of the taxpayers, drop everything. That's exactly what's going to happen. And, I mean, you can see it playing out. These people, corruption is pretty predictable. That's how I'm able to figure this stuff out.
Well, that's a good point. Yeah. Well, and she's not running again.
Right.
So you could, they could push it to December and wait, or, January, I guess is when everyone files, and say, hey, she didn't file, so that means that we can just go ahead and drop this. I thought it was interesting in the article how it said that her lawyer objected because of the timing, it wasn't convenient. And so I posted on somebody, whoever posted that, maybe it was Tom Mark, if I remember, I said, well, that's pretty convenient that the lawyer was able to say something and object, because I was never able to object. I mean, I wasn't given that same treatment. I know that they just wanted me out of there, and they were using that as an excuse, but again, it's very hypocritical, as you said the whole time.
It's just vile. The level of corruption, it's at such a level that they're open and transparent about it. They don't care. They're like, oh yeah, let's postpone this thing. They'll be like, oh, we object. Well, sorry. Okay. It's all just, it's ridiculous. And like I said, I thought to myself, all right, let's put my mind in the mind of corrupt people, and how would this play out? How would I help play this out? And this is exactly it. That's how I knew that it would start playing out this way, and it has been for months now.
Well, and the thing that I would wonder is, don't we just the appearance of corruption and the appearance of bias? I would say, doesn't this have the appearance of being biased, even if you don't think you are? Don't you think a reasonable person? But I guess if you don't think like that, maybe you don't.
Well, and that's part of my point, is that when you get to a point of such corruption, you don't even try to hide it anymore. Just blame about it. Because if you have that attitude, what are they going to do? Screw them. I'll do what I want to do. And it's obvious. And they do. They live in their own little bubble. And this is part of the problem. There are a lot of problems. I swear, they need to, one of the things they need to do is change the way that the wards or districts, whatever they're called, are divided up. Because it's set up like a four-square now. The zones. It's set up like four-square. And so they all can live virtually in the same neighborhood, which they all virtually do. So the people who live in, the average $60,000-$70,000 home on the north side, they don't have any true representation. They need to have parallel wards. They need to be along the, or something that separates it up. And I talked about this with Tom Arts, and someone said, well, that kind of seems like overreach by government because, you know, we don't like the way the elections are upcoming, and they're, you know, and people, they're making these decisions. But government's going to design these districts. And so if they're going to design them, they ought to be designed in a way that makes it less likely that all of these people can come from the same little cluster. And, you know, because otherwise their people, their neighborhoods are deciding for the north side, for the east side, for the west side. I mean, it's just the whole thing. It's a ridiculous, rigged system. They think that they're above it all.
Yeah, and, you know, I think there's a group or two that are moving to try to work on a new charter and maybe try to change that because they don't run as a party, so when people vote for them, they don't know their names. They're not able to see what party they're with. I don't know if that helps or not, because I don't know if they've actually put Republican. I know for sure the ones that were Democrats that were very, very liberal, hot, corn chilling, they were in the state house.
Right.
So
yeah, but I can see people like Jan Fisk claiming they were Republican. You know, I could see that happening just with the election. I mean, it happens on a state lawmaker level around here, people that are actually Democrats, but they run as Republicans because they know that that's how they have to run in order to win.
You're listening to the best of Nick Reed on Springfield's Talk 101.
Hi, I'm Dr. Nia Hurd-Garris with today's tip for kids from the American Academy of Pediatrics. Every year, hundreds of teens drown. If your teen hasn't learned to swim yet, it's never too late. Even if your teen is a strong swimmer, make sure to supervise kids of any age. No one should swim alone. Teach them to enter the water feet first, wear life jackets in the boat, and never use alcohol or drugs on the water. Drowning is preventable. For more, visit healthychildren.org.
Jail left and right, and I mean, isn't that what conservatives do? And so I want to explain all all of that, because it seems like a contradiction, but it's not. First, though, I wanted to get your thoughts. I don't know if you've heard this audio, some of the most recent audio, when she was the Attorney General in California, and she was speaking about young people before the Ford Foundation.
What else do we know about this population, 18 to 24? They are stupid. That is why we put them in dormitories. And they have a resident assistant. They make really bad decisions.
So, working for the youth vote there, 18 to 24-year-olds are really stupid. That's why we corral them in dorms. Now, while there may be a lot of folks who agree with that, what I find particularly interesting is that Kamala Harris having that perspective of how stupid they are, yet they do everything they can to get them out the vote. What does that tell you?
Oh, yeah. And do these kids not understand what they're saying, what you're saying about them? And, you know, the first thing that I thought of when you played that, because I hadn't heard that before, is how elitist are you? I mean, it just goes with the other Democrats that are in power right now. I mean, you're going to talk down to, and I can tell, like, if we're trying to make a joke, but that's not even something you make a joke. I mean, I can't even imagine what her, Biden's saying, what they're going to say. And then the media is going to give them a pass. It's like, she almost can't control what she says either.
It's all cover for her. It's all make sure. That's why they're out there trying to convince people that she's a moderate. Because it's all trying, and setting the stage, you can't criticize her because she is a woman and a minority. And she certainly isn't going to get treated the way Sarah Palin was as a female vice presidential candidate.
I thought about that too yesterday. Well, it's interesting, Giuliani, I think it was Laura Ingraham, he was on show last night with Huckabee, and he was interviewing him. He was talking about what a terrible prosecutor she was in California. And as Attorney General, so I hope on the merits we do it again into the debate and talk about the, you know, serious violent killers that she didn't prosecute and an unequal, I guess, application of justice in her state. I hope that people listen to that, but I don't know. I still think Trump's gonna win.
Yeah. Well, I guess.
But, you know, oh, go ahead.
No, you got the last 25 seconds.
Oh, okay. I was just gonna say, you know. In these local areas, and you know, people call me all the time, and they're like, "What can I do?" And I saw this quote yesterday. I thought this is really interesting. I just ran across it. It said, "If you don't fight for what you want, don't cry for what you're going to lose." And so, I mean, if people are worried that their freedoms are being taken away, they need to get involved in this election and get involved in our municipalities. And if it's a recall, it's a recall. So, I'm just saying that people need to
do something. Chrissy Konecki, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Coming up in 60 seconds, I'm Nick Reed.
You're listening to the best of Nick Reed on Springfield 101.
Lace the Bees Christian County Food Pantry continues to serve the most vulnerable in our community amid the COVID-19 pandemic. It is our commitment to continue to serve families in need in Christian County. Due to the loss of jobs, many families in our community need our help. Lace the Bees is able to purchase $10 worth of food for every dollar donated. Our community is counting on you. Will you please donate today? You can donate online at leastofthesefoodpantry.org.
Reaching out, providing hope, and changing lives. Brooke Catholic Charities of Southern Missouri. Connect with us on Facebook or visit ccsomo.org and learn how you can help.
Couple of signal light problems along Chestnut Expressway in Springfield, one of the westbound Chestnut in Maine, and the other westbound Chestnut in Broadway. The signals are flashing at both of those intersections. Otherwise, no major slowdowns in the open traffic cameras, so traffic's still pretty light in glimpse of the sunshine. And now the Jake Cooper traffic's picking up, but moving along okay. From the KTTS Go Patrol Traffic Center, I'm Don Luzer. The KTTS first weather forecast, cloud today with a 30% chance for showers and storms. We've already seen some heavy rain up around the Bolivar and Hathaway areas. High today at 90, heat index 97. 30% chance for showers and storms tonight, down to 71. And becoming sunny tomorrow, high at 89. It is 73 at Springfield's Talk 104.1. I'm Todd Luzinger in the KTTS 24-Hour News Center in Springfield, 73 degrees. This heavy rain is above the Springfield around the Bolivar area and just south of the halfway area as well. Well, the Springfield School District is working with local health officials to track down possible COVID-19 exposures in two schools. Someone at the YMCA before an after-school program at Gray Elementary has tested positive. And someone who attended the sixth grade orientation at Reed Academy on Thursday tested positive. District has notified people who may have been inactive. And the Missouri Department of Health and Senior Services reporting more than 1,300 new coronavirus cases on Wednesday, along with 10 additional deaths. Arkansas has more than 600 new cases and 21 new deaths. We have more of the best of Nick Reed coming up next on Springfield's Talk 104.1.